Alright, so we're going to do 10 minutes with this little Caracal. Alright, look at this cute little rascal. Let's see what we can do with him. Alright. Okay, starting out well. Let's see. His cute little nose. 8 minutes left. I can already see a few problems. I'm just gonna come back to that mouth because it's bugging me. Hopefully you can't hear that exercising in the background. It's a little distracting, but we'll work through it. I know what I'm doing. I'm not putting enough here. Yeah, that's what I was doing wrong. Oh, 3 minutes left. I ruined this one. Finally got it looking decent. Okay. Might be the worst one yet. Eyes are way too far from his head. And I only have 18 seconds left. Not good. Alright, so I'm going to redo this guy's eyes because it looked terrible. I might redo some of the body too because it looks embarrassing. Alright, so So his forehead goes here, his nose, the top of his nose here. Let's make this other line about there. Okay, so that's this area. And his eyes pretty much go right into that brow. And it looks like his eyes are tucked right into that corner. So that's a good way for me to make sure they're in the right position. If I also tuck them into that corner. Just get them fairly, they're even size. Even that looks a lot better to me. All right, so give him some tone that might help him too. So let me just simplify some of these lines here, because sometimes it can just get really muddy. And I kind of lose my, sketch, and it'll make me, I can kind of get lost sometimes. So sometimes I just need to simplify. Like if you think about, you know, Disney and a lot of characters and stuff like that, the lines are really simple. Like all the characters are designed very simply. There's not that much nuance in the characters. They're all pretty simple, so sometimes I have to remember to do that here. looks a lot better. This eye looks a little small. Maybe the other one needed to be smaller. Yeah, that looks better. So here's these white. These white areas under his eyes. So I'm just gonna make his. I'm just gonna make everything darker. Except for those white areas. There's white underneath there too, so. To get better drawing on the clock. It's tough. This is a lot of pressure. Not to mention I've been away for the past few days, so I haven't really been a chance. I haven't really had a chance to draw. And you really have to like keep up with it, or else it just takes a little bit longer to get back into your groove. I think that's what it is. It's like you'll always be able to draw again. You'll be able to figure it out. It'll just take longer to figure it out, to get back into that place where you can just flow and all your drawings look good. And if you don't draw for a while and you come back, it's like, man, I forgot all the little cheats that I learned, you know, to make things look good. That's how I think of them. I just think of them as all like little cheats. I mean, they're not cheats, but they kind of are. Another layer for the eyes, just because I might have to do the eyes a bunch of times, because sometimes they just look bad. But that's, you know, sometimes can't always look good. I guess maybe if you're a better artist, better than me. Now, do I want to do, like, a cartoony eye, or do I want to do it true to... It's kind of fun. True to the picture. Now I can't draw it true to the picture, I have to draw it true to the other eye. That's not bad. First, let me fix this. Those are really cute, actually. Kind of like those. Not true to his eyes at all, but kind of cool looking. See what they look like if they're darker. Think. these guys. Alright, now I like to do a shadow. So I'm just going to make up a better looking leg. Maybe I don't want to... Maybe I don't want his leg to look like that even. That looks better. These big feet. Actually, it looks like this is angled down more. little like bobtails. Alright, so what I'll do to kind of clean him up. I mean, it looks better than it did. It looked terrible before. It's horrific. Some shadow here. Much better.